Some 12,000 athletes from 170 countries will be in Gwangju in South Korea for the 2015 Summer Universiade, the World University Games. It all begins on July the 3rd. So, with only weeks to go, the recent heads of delegation meeting was an opportunity to assess the preparations.
It's an advanced trip for the all the head of delegation, and they have the opportunity to visit the venues that we will host the games, to visit the village, and to have all information regarding the services that will be provided to the teams during the games.
110 delegates from 51 countries were there, including the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, North Korea. They came to look at issues like transport and accommodation, important issues for their athletes and coaches.
We always want to know exactly how everything is going to work on the transportation side, how it's going to work on the accreditation side. We've been through this many times, and you can tell that the organizing committee has also been paying attention to some other games, so it looks like everything is going to be smooth.
The inspection began with the baseball stadium. Baseball, the most popular sport in South Korea, and the Gwangju Tigers are one of their most successful teams. Their stadium will host the Universiade tournament. Among the delegates on the tour, Elizabeth Brett from Australia.
It gives us an opportunity to understand all the processes that are going to be involved in the games, and we can then go back to each of our sports managers and provide them with critical information on arrival, departures and the athlete villages. Plus, we also get to see all of the venues, which we think is great information to be able to provide to our athletes as well.
Kwangju has followed the eco-friendly rules laid down by FISU. 70% of the facilities already existed and have been renovated. Out of a total of 69 competition and training venues, only 3 have been built from scratch. The Nambu University Aquatic Center is one of them. Another new building is the multi-purpose gymnasium, which the artistic and rhythmic gymnastics competitions will be held. The heads of delegations seem to like what they saw. Here's Wang Gang from China. I can only say that the organizing committee has put a lot of effort into the preparations here. All the venues we've seen so far are well advanced and of a high standard. We believe that with this kind of top-level sports venue, the organization of this event will take place successfully. Gwangju is the 4th city in South Korea to host a Universiade, but this time limiting the costs has been a priority, and therein lies a difficulty. Because as far as FISU is concerned, at the core of the games are the athletes. And the athletes' village has to provide a comfortable environment for them. But at this stage, the standards of the village are not ideal.
Our main concern and the same concern as the head of delegation. So now they are visiting the village, and I know that they have some concern about the apartments, to be sure they will have enough furniture in the apartment, that there will be enough air conditioning in it. And when they have been visiting some venues, they were quite surprised also about the fact that some of the venues were still not refurbished.
There's still work to be done at several venues. The Gwangju University Gymnasium will host the preliminary rounds in basketball. But the refurbishment is not yet finished, and the volleyball venues still need some flooring.
Gwangju University Gymnasium, Dongguan College, Naju Multipurpose Gym, and Yangguang Sportium, while the training is at the Gwangju High School Gymnasium.
The third new venue is the archery range. It's still under construction. The delays on the project could hamper the all-important detailed preparations in the final weeks. FISU's Universiade Director is Marc VANDENPLAS.
It is really very important that everything is settled very, very quickly, because the venue management has to take possession of those spaces as soon as possible. And this is really, for them, it's the key of the success.
The opening ceremony of the University Games takes place at the beginning of July. Time is short. For the organizing committee, there's now a sense of urgency. But among the visitors, the talk at least is positive. The head of the British delegation is Andrew Hibbert.
So I'm absolutely confident that we'll go ahead as scheduled on time.
Back in 2002, Gwangju was one of the host cities for the Football World Cup. And in the same Gwangju Stadium, the opening and closing ceremonies will take place, as well as the athletics competitions. The Russians organized the highly successful University Games in Kazan 2 years ago. So what do they think now? Concerning the stadium, I think the organizers of the Universiade are doing their best. Everything's going to be finished. They're working on all those details that they haven't quite finished yet, as we've seen. Here and there, there are some repairs to do, some details to finish off. But I think it'll be a top-level venue. South Korea has great experience in organizing Universiades and also the Olympic Games in 1988. So I think they'll rise to the challenge and everything will be fine. So plenty of optimism that Gwangju will be all set by July. Her name is Hong Jong-ho, a handball Olympic champion in 1992 at the Barcelona Games. She also became world champion in 1995, and now she has a special reason to be pleased for her sport.
It's the first time in this Universiade Games, so I'm very happy to our handball can be in this Universiade, and I hope that many people come to the hall and see watch how handball is fun and dramatic sports.
Hong was there for the handball group draw, which took place during the visit of the international delegates. Handball's a very popular sport in South Korea, especially for women, and the draw was reasonably kind to them. China, Japan, and Ukraine, in this very first handball competition in Universiade history.
So Japan and China, and I don't know so much about Ukraine, but those teams are, used to play a lot, and so I know their level of the handball, so I think our group competition games will be not very difficult.
In men's handball, Portugal are the world university champions from last year, and they were drawn in Pool B with their biggest rivals, Brazil, in Group C, and ready for revenge.
We in the hand up, and we lost for Portugal, and now in the Universiades, we prepared our team for the champions.
In basketball, at the Kazan Universiade, Russia were the winners. They'll play in Pool B with Portugal. The USA is grouped with Serbia, the Kazan bronze medalists, Brazil, Turkey, Chile, and Switzerland.
And our men's actually going to be a unified university team, the University of Kansas, for the first time. We're experimenting with a different model. So we'll see how that goes.
In men's football, South Korea will face Canada, Italy, and Chinese Taipei in Pool A, while favorites like France, the winners last time, and Brazil were placed in Pool B and C, respectively. The women's Universiade champions, Brazil, are in a pretty tough group with China, Poland, and North Korea.
Our female team is a very good team. We have three or four players in the national team. It's possible we stay in the dispute for the championship.
In volleyball, the women's champions are Russia. In Group B, they'll face Taipei, Ukraine, and Switzerland. The silver medalists last time were Brazil. They're in Group C with Japan, the USA, and Finland. Russia are the favorites for another title, but there's no complacency in the Russian camp. It's difficult to judge how the teams will perform during the upcoming Universiade based on their previous Universiade performances. In the men's competition, Russia also come as champions and they're fancied to retain their title in Gwangju.
National University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values, excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.